Hi everyone, welcome back to another episode of A Lady's Garden. I just wanted to share with you guys some of the seeds and tubers I got for this season to plant. And these are so pretty, like I can't even contain myself how pretty they are. I'm so excited about planting dahlias. And then I found these are seeds. So we're gonna try to get both going. I think it's still too early. I usually wait till closer to Mother's Day to start planting any seeds outside. But I'm really looking forward to seeing, you know, the beauty of dahlias. And then I'm also going to share an update. Let me know if you guys have any experience planting dahlias or what type of methods you all use. I've seen a lot of YouTube videos, which are great by the way, of overwintering. I've seen some that they didn't even dig up the tubers at the end of the season. They just kind of insulated them. But if you have any experience with both, or you prefer one over the other, please let me know. I'd be very interested to find out. But let's take a look at the update with the garden beds that I was talking about in my last video. So let's take a look. As you can see, there are no garden beds. So the story is, it's trial and error sometimes with gardening. You think of something, you get the vision, and then you put it on paper, and you start to get excited, and it looks really great, and then, you know, I'm kind of gung-ho, let's start excavating. I did, and I even got as far as buying material, which I had decided I was going to use a paver, actually. It was supposed to be a paver, and I was going to stand a paver up and surround a bed. Once I got that far, and yes, I got that far, and I thankfully only bought enough pavers for one bed, I didn't like it. I did not like it. And I'll put the clip. I even taped everything. I documented the entire process up until the pavers went in. And then I stepped back and I looked at it and I said, oh dear, I don't think I like this. So let's take a look at that. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to dig it out, see what it looks like. If I don't like it, I can just put all the dirt back, sprinkle some grass seeds, hopefully maybe sprinkle some grass seeds everywhere else, and then get an actual lawn. But for now, I really, really would like to see a garden bed. So once, I think what happened, I underestimated, and I guess I did know, the space is a lot smaller than, it can't handle too many things going on. I mean, I guess on camera, even to my eye, on camera, it does look a little bigger, but because I had the idea of keeping the center open, as you can see, if you look through the center, you can see where I didn't, where the beds are. You can definitely see where the beds begun. And I wanted to keep that center open so you can see that statuary. Once it was excavated and the stone went in, it didn't look right. I didn't feel it. I really didn't feel it. And as much as I wanted the extra garden beds to plant the flowers, I think I'm happier with just the clean look without the extra garden beds. Now, I could have made the garden beds wider, and maybe that would have alleviated the awkwardness of the two skinny little garden beds, but instead of doing that, I said, you know what, let's just put it away. Maybe another season, maybe a better idea might come. As you can see in the video, I said if I didn't like it, I just put the dirt back. And that's exactly what I did. And just sprinkle some grass seeds. Maybe you'll start catching and spread everywhere else. And we'll have a nice little lawn back here. but that's just the truth of gardening. Sometimes you try things and it doesn't work out, and that's okay. That's totally okay. Nothing's going to be perfect. You're going to have weeds. You're going to have garden bed that, you know, might be too skinny, or it might expand. I mean, I couldn't tell you how many times this fence garden bed that I've expanded it. When I started, it was totally skinny. It was a really narrow garden bed. And then each year, for probably 3 years, I kept pulling the brick edging forward just to give myself more space so I can have that layered look. So it's totally a journey, totally an evolution of a space when you're creating one. And that's the beauty of gardening. But let's take a look at some other things going on over here. I have some new faces to welcome into the garden. Some new daffodils, new tulips, and then after I'll take a look at the container gardening with you guys as well. So here we are in the container garden, and we have some really healthy looking beautiful tulips coming up saying hello, telling me it's okay. You're still okay. It's okay, the garden bed didn't work out. But they look very lovely. I'm looking forward to seeing more of them. And hey, I'm going to keep gardening. I'm going to keep making mistakes. I'm going to keep having ideas, trying them out, and learning as we go along on this gardening journey together. I love my garden. I'm thankful for my garden. Okay, so that didn't work out, but we're still going to press on and keep moving. I mean, I guess I can say, thankfully, I did not do all four boxes. Thing is, I started off with one, and I got so excited with the one, I just went ahead and did the other one. Not really, you know, thinking, let's just try one. But thankfully, we only tried one with the brick. We didn't buy bricks for both of them, or all four of them. And yes, I did not waste those bricks. I kept my receipt, and I took them right back. They were in great condition. Just tried them out. It's not like, you know, returning food or anything. It's bricks. Someone else will get the use of them and get the blessing of using them. I had the blessing of trying them and have the blessing of taking them back. But nevertheless, I hope everyone has a great day. We're going to keep gardening, keep getting new ideas, keep showing you guys the ideas, and keep being inspired by, you know, your ideas if you post, and keep being inspired, hopefully, by my ideas. At least we can put this to bed, no pun intended, and move ahead. Happy gardening, fellow gardeners.